I'm Lacey from No Filter Beauty, and welcome to Hair Topper School, where I'm going to hold your hand through the transition of thinning hair to wearing hair. Let's talk about customization tips at the salon with your topper. A lot of people want to bypass this step, but let this sink in. You've already spent hundreds, maybe over $1,000 on your hair topper. What's a little bit more just to make sure that you absolutely love it? Keep in mind that when companies make these toppers, they're trying to make them fit a huge demographic of different women. And so it's probably probably 99% of the time not gonna come out of the box fitting you and looking perfect on you. This is when customization comes in, and I really, truly, I'm so passionate about this. You have to be willing to spend that extra time and money into making it perfect. And I promise you, if you follow these tips, you will love it even more. The first step is finding an excellent stylist. So preferably this is gonna be somebody who has experience working with alternative hair. If they're kind of few and far between. So if you can't find somebody who already has experience, maybe just go to your regular stylist or a recommended stylist and talk to them and ask them how they might feel about working on a topper. Now, some stylists absolutely refuse to because there is a liability and a risk because this hair doesn't grow back, right? So a lot of stylists are really terrified to do that. But if you can find one that's willing to try it, just follow the rest of these tips and I really think you're gonna be fine. Another thing you can do if you really can't find a stylist that's willing to do it for you is you can find one online that can do quite a bit through mail. So you can find, like on Instagram, find like an alternative hairstylist. And sometimes they, especially with color, they'll be able to do that. You can just mail it to them, they'll color it, mail it back. Cutting is a little bit harder if it's not actually on your head. So, but there are a few options you can do. You can also recommend a custom color or cut or style or something from the manufacturer or from the company that you're purchasing it from. That's probably an additional cost. And again, it's still not something they can put on your head and make sure it's perfect for you. So just be aware of that. I still think the best option is to find a stylist that can customize it for you on your head. When going to your appointment, make sure you wear your topper to the appointment. This will really help, I promise. Make sure that the part is exactly where you're going to wear it. If you want to be able to switch up the part, just part it down the middle to go to your appointment. And in order to switch up the part, you just need to wet the roots, use a comb to find the part, and then blow dry it in place. But then make sure, you may want to use a little bit of root powder on your hairline, blend the topper as best you can to work with your bio hair, and wear it to the appointment just like that, so that when your stylist is ready to start working on it, she knows what it's going to look like in the front and exactly where it's going to sit on your head, so that as she cuts it and colors it, it's all going to lay the way it's supposed to. I don't suggest just bringing your topper in a bag, because it's gonna take a long time to figure out where the part's gonna be, where to put it on. You're gonna wanna practice before you get to your appointment so that you're confident, or at least a little bit more confident on how to put it on and exactly where it will sit on your head. I promise this is gonna make all the difference. Okay, another thing you're gonna wanna do is bring pictures. Bring pictures of the color that you want and the cut and the style. All of those things, you're gonna wanna bring lots of inspiration pictures so that you and your stylist have exactly the same thing in mind. If you tell her, I just want a short bob or whatever, and you're vague, then mistakes are bound to happen and her vision is not gonna be the same as your vision. So a picture's worth 1,000 words. Bring all the inspiration pics you can and sit down with her or him. Make sure that they're listening to you and that they're willing to take it slowly and do what you want according to what your pictures say. Talking about color and hair toppers, most hair topper companies will tell you you are able to go darker if it's human hair, but try not to go lighter. The reason is because lightening the hair can really compromise the integrity of the hair. And again, because this hair is so fragile, there's no scalp oils, you know, hydrating it all the time, so it can get very dry and brittle a lot quicker than bio hair. You don't want to lighten it if you can avoid it. So in order to protect that integrity, plan on buying a topper that is on the lighter side of the spectrum if you're worried, and then darken it with hair color. Most stylists will use a demi-permanent hair color. Remember that you're not washing it a lot, so it should hold color pretty well. But again, just be very cautious about going lighter. If you do go lighter, you're gonna wanna keep it like just a very small amount of highlights in order to keep the integrity of the hair. Depending on the situation, it might be easier to dye your bio hair to match the hair topper hair. Remember, your bio hair is gonna keep growing and you can cut and moisturize, and it's not gonna be as dry as the topper hair. So you may consider that. I get my roots dyed all the time to match my topper hair because this doesn't fade as much as my bio hair does. If you're super insecure about what the hairline might look like, you may wanna get or consider getting a fringe or a bang, even like a curtain bang, something that will sort of hide that hairline a little bit, some side swept bangs maybe. Bangs can hide a multitude of sins. So I always suggest, especially for if you're new to alternative hair, we're always paranoid about people noticing, and a bang will make that a lot easier to deal with. Once you're more comfortable with wearing hair and you've worn it for quite a while, you realize that people really don't notice the hairline or the parting, that you're probably the only one thinking about it, and you get more comfortable with that. But in the beginning, if a bang or some kind of a fringe is gonna make you feel a little bit better, look for inspo pics for that and show that to your stylist and see what they can do. Again, just starting slowly. When it comes to length and your topper, you have a lot of leeway, actually. I think a lot of people are afraid that your hair, your bio hair is gonna have to match your topper length exactly, but it really doesn't necessarily. Sometimes, depending on how thick your topper is, you might be able to just leave it kind of a blunt cut and leave it longer than your bio hair. That's totally fine. If it's really thin on the ends and you wear it longer than your bio hair, it might look too stringy. You'll just have to, it just depends on the topper. But you also are able to grow your bio hair out longer than your topper. And a lot of times it just gives it a little bit of a layered look until your hair gets too long and you can see a definite line. You'll probably want to go get your hair trimmed. But this is just something, it's a little bit of a misconception. You don't have to continually get your hair cut all the time. It just depends on your style and your topper style and how thick it is through the ends. But usually you have a lot of leeway with the length. I'm going to go over a few common customizations with hair toppers. A lot of hair toppers, especially silk tops, are very heavy through the front. It tends to fall in your face and kind of like move forward like this. And so you're gonna be like constantly pushing it out of your face. So a lot of people will choose to do some face framing layers and sometimes a little bit of thinning throughout the front area. I've already mentioned this tip like 12 times, but go slowly, okay? This hair doesn't grow back and it's hard to fix if it gets really messed up. So honestly, a few appointments with very subtle changes is so much better than one appointment with drastic changes. So what I mean by this is I've taken the same topper to my stylist sometimes like 3 times. I go the first time, we just do something very small, like she'll trim it just to kind of match my length. And then I go home and I try it out. Then I come back and I'm like, okay, I think I want some face framing layers, or this feels a little too heavy. Can we lighten this with just a few layers? And she'll do that. And then I'll go home and then I make another appointment and I come back and I say, okay, I can't love the hairline. The hairline's driving me crazy. I think I just need some bangs in it, and she'll cut some bangs. So again, just taking it slowly. I know that it's frustrating and you don't want to pay for multiple appointments, but I promise you, if you just go in and do a bunch of cutting and a bunch of coloring and everything in one appointment and you go home and you don't love it, you've wasted all of that. So I really, really suggest going slowly, and make sure that your stylist is. Again, if they're overconfident in their ability, maybe take a step back and be like, I just want to go really, really slowly, and just really fight for yourself, because you've invested a lot of money in this topper and you really don't want it screwed up. And I promise you, your stylist doesn't want to screw it up either. So just remember to be patient and take it slow. I hope that you'll be open to the idea of customizing your topper so that you can enjoy it to its full potential. Just make sure that you find somebody you trust, that you wear your topper to your appointment, you take inspiration pictures, and that you go slowly.